In the first hydro video, you guys saw us do the easier part of doing a hydraulic e-brake, which was welding the bracket and getting everything mounted up. Today, in part two, we're going to be doing the more scary side. We're going to be drilling holes in my car and cutting my brake line into bits, and then putting in some new brake lines and praying to God that they do something.
So now the hydro is all mounted, we're about to start running the lines, and so we have the inlet line right here, and we're going to bend it. Problem.
Look, we made a puzzle.
Shit.
So we've got a couple of bends in, and it turns out running the lines just in front of the e-brake and straight down next to the seat is a darn near perfect place to join into the brake line. So you can see right here, if I go straight down, bam, brake lines. There is the brake line. It's the small one next to all the fuel lines.
We're going to pull out the seats so it's easier to get in where the lines need to go.
So the tubing bends so far are aligned pretty nicely, and in order to keep from interfering with the seat and the brackets, because they bolt in down here, we're going to try to dip it straight down in, pretty much right in line with the center console, beneath the carpet, and then it'll go ahead and exit about 2.5 inches behind the front seat bolt. So it'll probably be coming out right about here, and that should get it out of the car safely.
So you can see the lines right there. And I've measured directly behind
the right distance and already drilled a little pilot hole right here. And so I'm just going to go ahead and finish that off with a larger bit. All right.
Here's the hole that was made by the drill bit. And I can see that I want the line to go into the carpet right about here.
There it is, mocked up, sticking out just a little bit. And I think we're going to have to make some changes, but it looks pretty nice.
We have the line that is going to come from the inlet. It is a 1/4 inch line coming from the back here, and we need to reduce it to a 3/16 line. So we have all these fittings to make it reduce from 1/4 to a 3/16. Big old pain in the ass.
Jonas has got the line there, and it's running through just on the low side of the tunnel here. And so what we decided we'd do is go ahead and see if we can bend it. We need to match it up to the brake line right here. Since that's the inlet, we're gonna cut and hook it up here, and then cut and plumb the outlet here. So I remove the clamp here and here, and that gives me more than enough room to be able to cut this line in the two places we talked about.
We've got the brake line all cut up, and now we're using this Dremel tool with the rounded end on it, and we're just going to use that to grind down the brake line. Then we're going to flare it and make good connections. Look pretty goddamn good to me.
Holy Taylor. Cow, that might work.
Yeah, ain't nothing like working.
Let's just see what kind of a treasure awaits, because this is clearly not right. Something bad is happening here. It looks like shit, that's for sure. I guess I'll get a little more practice cutting. The input line is ready to accept this little connector. Put that on now. I put a zip tie around one of the bolts because it makes contact with the fuel line, so this plastic should keep it from wearing badly, and then just barely snugged it up so it shouldn't move at all. So that one's pretty solid. They're tightened down, ready to go, and so now we're moving on to the output line.
So now we've got the hydro's output line all plumbed in too. We bend it to sit next to the console, tucked behind the input line, then poke down under the car just in front of the input line.
So under the car, we've got the lines coming in from the cabin, and then we have the inlet coming from the ABS and then coming here and kind of crossing over the top of the fuel lines. And, you know, it's still under the frame rails, so we won't have to worry about them
getting mashed or anything. And then we have the outlet line coming back through and actually tucking under the fuel lines. None of these lines have kinks in them, which is super important, because if there's a kink, you're not going to get brake fluid to your brakes, and that would suck. Pro tip, make sure you have brakes.
So we got the hydro all plumbed in, and we learned a lot doing this. Geez, I don't even know where to start. So plumbing the lines was a way bigger pain in the ass than we expected it to be, especially since we had to take the quarter inch line and then plumb that to a 3/16 line. You have to order those fittings, because we asked Napa, O'Reilly's, and we went to Ace Hardware, and we couldn't find any of them. So we just ended up ordering them online, and it sucked. We spent more on the lines and on the fittings than we did on the actual hydro. It's a lot more work, in my opinion, than it's worth. I think next time I put a hydro in a car, I'm just going to save up and pay the $200 for a legit hydraulic e-brake. Overall, I think it took like 3 large sessions of work. I mean, now that it's in, it looks really nice. It's plumbed really well. We did a really good job of everything. It's all right, but it's wobbly. Like, the handle is wobbly. And so there's all that play that we want to try to shim out. What we have left to do is bleed the brakes. The brakes are now bled, and the hydro does not work how it's supposed to. When you pull the hydro, you're supposed to be able to just kind of little tiny pull and lock up the rear wheels. I have a lot of pull, and the wheels do not lock. As hard as I can pull, as quick as I pull it, it does not lock up the rear wheels. Apparently, it's a very common problem, so we're going to be fixing that in the next hydro video. We'll also be making a new handle for the hydro, because I'm not really feeling the brass handle that we made. So, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. Got lots and lots of videos. The last 3 weeks have been crazy. We've been doing tons of filming, and there's probably 6 or 7 videos that we've got. So hopefully over the next 2 weeks we'll be able to chill out a little bit, edit those videos, and get them out to you. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take it easy.